Hi, assalamualaikum and a very good morning. So now we are in chapter 7, Ionic Equilibrium. And today we're going to focus on the subtopic of 7.1 acid and bases, part 2 of the video. So in this video, we're going to learn about the relationship between pH and pOH, in which we're going to relate that with the ionic product of water, which is Kw at the specific temperature of 25 degrees Celsius. Next, we're going to learn to calculate the pH values for the strong acid as well as the strong base. So the linear outcome of D and E will be covered in this video, which is in part 2. Meanwhile, the linear outcome of A, B, and C, we have looked about that in the previous video, which is in part 1. So without any further ado, let us start with part 2 of the video first. So pH and pOH, what is that? So as what you can see here, it's showing a pH scale in which we have a value of from 0 to 7 up to 14. So the region between 0 to 7 here, referring to the acidic region in which the concentration of H plus to be higher than the OH minus. At the neutral state, which is at pH 7, we know that the concentration of the H plus will be equal to the concentration of the hydroxide. Meanwhile, at the basic region, the concentration of the hydroxide ion will be larger than the H plus. So therefore, the studying of pH basically helps us to specify the acidity or the basicity of an aqueous solution. And pH basically equal to the formula of negative log, where P here refer to the negative log, and then our H refer to the H plus aqueous ion. And by definition, it is referring to the negative logarithm of the hydrogen ion or the hydronium concentration. And if our concentration of the H plus higher, then our value of pH is going to be lower, and it's showing that it is a more acidic region. So the pH value of 1 is more acidic than the pH value of 4. And we can also use pH to determine the basicity. The higher the pH is going to be the more basic the solution is. And we can also use the value of pOH for the basicity, in which we measure the concentration of the hydroxide ion. So we're going to have the expression of pOH equal to the negative logarithm of the OH minus, where similarly, P refer to the negative log, and then the OH refer to the concentration of the hydroxide ion. So the higher the concentration of the hydroxide ion, the lower you're going to be the pOH. Okay, and as a result, the pH is going to be higher. Okay, so they are inversely proportional here. And if the concentration of the hydroxide ion, it become more basic and will have a higher pH. And on the next slide, we're going to see the relationship between pH with pOH by relating it with the ionic product of water. So let us go to the next slide. So now we're going to relate the Kw, pH, and pOH at 25 degrees Celsius. And at our syllabus, we're just going to look at this constant temperature, which is at 25 degrees. So for the water, let's say if we have a pure water here, which is the H2O. So the H2O can dissociate in order to form H plus aqueous ion as well as the hydroxide ion. And if we were to write the Kc expression, we're going to get the concentration of the H plus aqueous ion multiplied by the another concentration of the product, which is the hydroxide ion, divided by the concentration of the water. However, as what you have learned in the previous chapter, the concentration of the pure liquid water is assumed to be constant, so it's going to be ignored. So lastly, we're going to get Kc is equal to H plus multiplied by the OH minus. And this Kc here related specifically for water. So this is also equivalent to Kw. And the concentration of the H plus and OH minus at 25 degrees Celsius is fixed to be 1 times 10 to the power of negative 7 molar. By understanding this information, we can substitute that in order to find our Kw. So as mentioned, H plus and OH minus concentration is 1 times 10 to the power of negative 7. So if we have the Kw here to be like this, then we can substitute 1.1 0 times 10 to the power of negative 7 multiplied by the same number, and hence we're going to get to the power of 2. So when we expand that, we're going to get kW to be 1.0 times 10 to the power of negative 14. And from this equation here, you can also put a negative logarithm on both sides. So you can make it be negative log h plus multiplied by oh minus, and it is also equal to the negative logarithm of the kW, which is the water ionization constant. And you can expand the logarithm part here, in which it equal to the negative log h plus to the negative log of the OH minus, and it is equal to the log kW, in which the kW here will have a value of 1 times 10 to the power of negative 14. And as what you have learned, the negative log of h plus is basically equal to pH, and then the plus sign will maintain as plus sign, and the negative log of OH minus basically equal to the pOH. Okay? And if you were to substitute this inside the calculator, you're going to get it to be 14. So you're going to get pH plus pOH is equal to pKW, which is also equal to 14. And this is the equation that we're going to relate the pH and pOH, in which we have the equal to 14. And this equation here is very, very important, because it's going to help us to solve problem. So in order to calculate the pH and pOH for the solution, let us look into the example. So for example, number one, we need to calculate the concentration of H plus and determine the pH in a solution in which the concentration of H plus is 1.0 times 10 to the power of negative 3 molar. So in order to find pH, we know that the pH is equal to the negative logarithm of the hydrogen ion, and the concentration of hydrogen ion is given to be in the equation, which is 1 times 10 to the power of negative 3. So we're going to substitute it directly, in which you're going to get negative log of this value. And once we put that inside the calculator, you're going to get the pH to be 3. And for question number 2 here, we are given the concentration of the OH minus, which is 2.5 times 10 to the power of negative 3. Okay, so when we are given the concentration of OH minus, we can find the pOH first, because the pOH is equal to negative log of the OH minus ion. Okay, so we're going to substitute the value in here, and then once we put that inside the calculator, you're going to get the pOH to be 2.6. But the question asks to find the pH. So the pH is basically equal to pOH is equal to 14, as what shown in the derivation. Hence, we can bring the pOH to the right hand side, and therefore 14 minus 2.6, and we're going to get the pH to be 11.4. And from here, you can also calculate the concentration of H plus, because you know that pH is equal to the negative log of H plus. So your pH is 11.4, and then it's going to get the negative log of H plus. You're going to bring the negative side to the left, and then bring the log to the left hand side as well. So you're going to get 10 to the power of negative 11.4. And once you put that inside the calculator, you're going to get the concentration of H plus to be 3.98 times 10 to the power of negative 12 molar. Okay, so this is all for example number 1. For example number 2, we need to calculate the pH of 0.15 mole dm cubed for the HCl solution. So here is the example for the strong acid. So first thing first, you need to write the equation. So HCl is a strong acid, so it's gonna dissociate completely in water in order to produce H plus aqueous ion, as well as the Cl minus aqueous ion. And from here, we can do the if table, because it is a strong acid, it's gonna be initial straight away to final. So initially, it's gonna have 0.15 molar, and it does not have any ions here in the beginning, so it's gonna be 0 and 0. But at the final stage, in which it has successfully dissociated, it's going to be 0 here, and it's going to be 0.15 and 0.15 for the chloride ion. But what we are interested in is the H+, because the H+ is used in order to calculate the pH. So we know that pH is equal to negative log H plus. So the negative log of 0.15 molar. And then once we substitute that inside the calculator, then we know that our pH is 0.82. And this is very, very logical because pH that is very, very close to zero means that it is very, very strong. Okay? Now, for example number 3, we need to calculate the pH for 0.001 molar solution of the calcium hydroxide. So for calcium hydroxide, it is also showing a strong base properties. So as usual, we need to write the equation first for the dissociation. So we have the CaOH2 aqueous. When it dissociates fully, it's going to produce Ca2 plus aqueous ion plus 2 OH minus aqueous ion, in order to balance the coefficient so that we got the balance equation. And we can use the if double, which is the initial as well as the final. So initially we got the concentration of the CaOH2 to be 0.011 molar, and the ions are going to be 0 and 0. And at the final stage, we're going to get the final concentration of the CaOH2, going to be 0. Meanwhile, for the Ca2 plus, it's going to be 0.011. However, for the hydroxide, it's going to be 2 multiplied by 0.011 because it has the stoichiometry of 2 here. Okay, so we're going to get the concentration final for the hydroxide, going to be 0.022. Okay, and from here, we can calculate the pOH first. So our pOH is basically equal to the negative logarithm of OH minus, and then we're going to substitute that in where we're going to get the pOH to be 2.66. And then we can use the relation of pH plus pOH is equal to 14. So we can get our pH by deducting it with pOH value, which is 2.66. And once we put that inside the calculator, we're going to get the pH to be 11.34. Now for the last question, which is example number 4, we need to calculate the pH of an aqueous solution containing 0.7 gram NaOH inside the 485 ml of water. So let's say if we have 485 ml and we're going to put a solid NaOH. Okay, so when it dissolves, it's going to produce a NaOH solution. So the NaOH solution here is a strong base. Okay, so the first thing first, we need to find the concentration for the NaOH. So the idea that we can do that is we need to find the number of mole and we need to divide it with the volume. So the number of mole can be obtained by dividing the mass with the molar mass, and then the volume need to be in the unit of liter, which is 0.485 liter. Okay, so we need to find the number of mole, which is the mass divided by molar mass, 0.7 divided by the molar mass 23 plus 16 plus 1, which is 40. So once we do that, we're going to get the mole to be 0.0175 mole. And then in order to find the concentration, number of mole divided by the volume of the solution. So 0.0175 divided by 0.485, which is in liter. So the concentration that we're going to get once we calculated that in, we're going to get to be 0.0361 molar. Okay, and as what you know, the NaOH will dissociate completely in order to produce Na plus aqueous ion as well as the hydroxide aqueous ion. Okay, so we're going to put it inside here and use the if table because it is a strong base. So initially, it got a concentration of 0.0361, the ion is going to be 0 and 0. But at the final stage in which it has fully dissociated, this is going to be 0 and the ions will get 0.0361 and 0.0361 respectively. And we are interested with the hydroxide ion. So we can find the pOH first, in which it equal to the negative log of 0.0361. And we're going to get the value of pOH to be 1.44. And since we need to find the pH, we can use the relation of pH plus pOH is equal to 14. And then the pH is equal to 14 minus 1.44. And lastly, we're going to get the pH for the NaOH solution to be 12.56. And this is logical because for the basic, it needs to be approaching to 14. And this really shows a strong base because it's closer to 14. Okay, so I think that's all for this video. See you again some other time. Bye!